Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, let us solve the problem 1 to 4 of exercise 4.5 of chapter 4 determinants of 12th class math. This exercise is based on the subtopic adjoint and inverse of a matrix. Okay. So let us look at the first question. Find adjoint of each of the matrices in exercises 1 and 2. We have to find the adjoint of the given matrix. Let us start. So, solution. Let us call this some name. So, let A be equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. This is a 2 by 2 matrix. So, we can directly find the adjoint. So, what we will get? Adjoint of A will be equal to, how to find the adjoint of the matrix directly? So, this diagonal which is there, you have to look at the elements and interchange them here. And these elements which are there, you have to change the sign without interchanging them. So, what you do? First interchange the elements of this diagonal. So, 4 and 1 you will get, and change signs of these elements, that is minus 3, minus 2. Okay. So, that will be the adjoint of the given matrix. That is the answer. Now, let us go to the next problem. Here we have 3 by 3 matrix, 1, minus 1, 2, 2, 3, 5, minus 2, 0, 1. We have to find the adjoint. Now you cannot directly find the adjoint here. Okay. So what you have to do first? Find the cofactors and then find the adjoint. So A11, that is the first cofactor, cofactor of the element A11. Okay. So, what it will be? Formula is minus 1 raised to the sum of the suffices. So, what it is? 1 plus 1 multiplied by find the determinant. So, what we will get? 3 times 1 is 3 and 0 times 5 is 0. So, minus 0. What you do? Hide the first row and the first column, right? To find the cofactors, hide the first row and the first column. So, determinant of 3, 5, 0, 1. So, that is 1 multiplied by 3 is 3 minus, which is in the formula, 0 multiplied by 5, which is 0. So, this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 2 times 3. So, this will be equal to 1 times 3, which is 3. Now we will find A12. So that is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2. Now we have to hide the first row and the second column. So what you will get? Determinant of 2, 5 minus 2, 1. So that is 1 times 2 is 2 and minus, which is in the formula, minus 2 times 5, which is minus 10. So, this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 3 times 2 plus 10, and that will be equal to minus 1 times 2 plus 10 is 12, which is equal to minus 12. Now, A13 let us find, minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3. So, you have to hide the first row and the third column. Determinant of 2, 3 minus 2, 0, right? So, 0 times 2 is 0, minus of minus, minus 2 times 3 is minus 6. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4 times 6, 0 minus of minus 6, that is 0 plus 6, which is 6. So, this will be equal to 1 times 6, that is equal to 6. Now, A21 let us find. A21 will be minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1 multiplied by Now we have to hide the second row and the first column. So determinant of minus 1, 2, 0, 1. So 1 times minus 1 is minus 1 and minus 0 times 2 is 0. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 3 times minus 1, which is equal to minus 1 raised to 3 is minus 1 multiplied by minus 1, which is 1. Okay. Then A22. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. We have to hide the second row and the second column. So determinant of 1, 2, minus 2, 1. So 1 times 1 is 1, minus of minus 2 times 2 is minus 4. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4, 1 plus 4. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4 is 1 multiplied by 1 plus 4 is 5. That is equal to 5. So A23 minus 1 raised to 2 plus 3. We have to hide the second row and the third column. Determinant of 1 minus 1 minus 2 0. So 0 times 1 is 0 minus of minus 2 times minus 1, that is 2. So you will get minus 1 raised to 5 times minus 2. This is nothing but minus 1 times minus 2, which is 2. Then we will find A31. So minus 1 raised to 3 plus 1. We have to hide the third row and the first column. So determinant of minus 1, 2, 3, 5. So 5 multiplied by minus 1, that is minus 5, minus 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4. Minus 5 minus 6 is minus 11. This will be equal to 1 times minus 11. That is equal to minus 11. Then we will find A32. So this will be minus 1 raised to 3 plus 2. Hide the third row, second column. 5 times 1 is 5. Minus 2 times 2 is 4. So this will be equal to minus 1 times 5 multiplied by 1. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 5 is minus 1 times 1, which is minus 1. Okay. Then we will find A33. So that is nothing but minus 1 raised to 3 plus 3 multiplied by, we have to hide the third row and the third column. So determinant of 1 minus 1, 2, 3. 3 multiplied by 1 is 3, minus 2 multiplied by minus 1 is minus 2. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 6, 3 plus 2. This will be equal to 1 times 5, that is 5. Okay. We have got every cofactor here. Now we can write the adjoint. So adjoint of A will be equal to transpose of the matrix A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So that is nothing but transpose of matrix. Now we can substitute every cofactor here. A11 is 3. A12 is minus 12. A13 is 6. A21 is 1. A22 is 5. A23 is 2. A31 is minus 11. A32 is minus 1 and A33 is 5. So, this is nothing but adjoint of A, not yet, transpose of this we have to find. So, adjoint of A will be transpose of this matrix. So, rows and columns will get interchanged. First row will become first column. So, 3 minus 12, 6. Second row will become second column, 1, 5, 2. And third row will become third column, minus 11, minus 1, 5. Okay. So, this is the final answer, adjoint of A. That was problem number 2. Let us go to problem 3 now. Question is verify A adjoint A is equal to adjoint A times A, which is equal to determinant of A times I in exercises 3 and 4. So, solution. What we have to do? Verify A times adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A times A equal to determinant of A times I. Let us call this matrix A. Let A be equal to 2, 3, minus 4, minus 6. Adjoint of A we can directly find here. Adjoint of A will be equal to, so interchange this diagonals element. So, minus 2, 2, and change the sign of these diagonal elements. So, 4 and minus 3. This is the adjoint. Now, let us start verifying this. We will start with A times adjoint of A. That will be equal to matrix 2, 3, minus 4, minus 6, which is A, times adjoint of A, which is minus 6, minus 3, 4, 2. So, this will be equal to what? We have to multiply first row with first column. So, minus 12, okay, 2 times minus 6 is minus 12, plus 3 times 4 is plus 12. Then first row, second column, 2 times minus 3 is minus 6, 3 times 2 is plus 6. Then second row, first column, minus 4 minus 6, that is minus 24, plus 24, and minus 6 plus 4 is minus 24. Then minus 4 minus 3 is 12, and minus 6 multiplied by 2 is minus 12. Okay. So, what we got here? This is equal to minus 12 plus 12 is 0, minus 6 plus 6 is 0, 24 minus 24 is 0, 12 minus 12 is 0. So, this is A times adjoint of A. Now, we will find adjoint of A times A. We will call this as equation 1, the previous A times adjoint of A equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, let us find adjoint of A times A. Adjoint of A is minus 6, minus 3, 4, 2. Times A, that is 2, 3 minus 4 minus 6. So, this will be equal to, we have to multiply the first row, first column. So, minus 6 times 12 is minus 12, minus 3 times minus 4 is plus 12, first row, second column. Minus 6 times 3 is minus 18, minus 3 minus 6 is plus 18. Second row, first column, 4 times 2 is 8, 2 times minus 4 is minus 8. Second row, second column, 4 times 3 is 12, 2 times minus 6 is minus 12. So what we have got is minus 12 plus 12 is 0, minus 18 plus 18 is 0, 8 minus 8 is 0, 12 minus 12 is 0. So this was adjoint of A times A. So we will call this as 2. Now we have to find determinant of A times I. So for that we have to find determinant of A. Determinant of A will be determinant of 2, 3 minus 4 minus 6. So this will be equal to 6 times 2 is 12 minus 4 times 3 is minus 12. Here it is minus 6, ok. So, minus 6 times 2 is minus 12 and minus of minus 4 times 3 is minus 12. So, minus 12 plus 12, that is nothing but 0. Determinant of A is 0. Now, we can find determinant of A times I. So, that will be nothing but 0 times identity matrix, which is 1 0 0 1, and so that will be equal to what? This 0 is a scalar, we have to multiply it to this matrix. That means we have to multiply 0 to each and every element of the matrix. So 0 0 0 0, ok. So this we will call it as 3. Now if you look at the equations 1 2 and 3, they are equal. A times adjoint of A is the 0 matrix, adjoint of A times A is also 0 matrix, and also determinant of I is 0 matrix, ok. So from 1, 2 and 3, we get A times adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A times A, which is equal to determinant of A times I. So this only we wanted to verify, and we verified it. So hence verified. So that was problem 3. Now let us go to problem 4. Here you have 3 by 3 matrix, and same thing we have to verify. A times adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A times A, which is equal to determinant of A times I. Let us call this matrix A. So let A be equal to 1 minus 1 2, 3 0 minus 2, 1 0 3. We have to find the cofactors to find the adjoint of A. So A 1 1 will be equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 multiplied by, hide the first row first column. So 3 times 0 is 0, minus 0 times minus 2 is 0. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 2 times 0, which is 0. Then A 1 2, so minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2, hide the first row second column. 3 times 3 is 9, minus 1 times minus 2 is minus 2. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 3, 9 plus 2, so this will be equal to minus 1 times 11, which is equal to 11. Now A 1 3 minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3, 1 first column you have to hide, and the first row you have to add in the third column. So 0 times 3 is 0, minus 1 times 0 is 0. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4 times 0, that will be equal to 0. A 2 1, this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1. So second row and the first column we have to hide. 3 times minus 1 is minus 3, and minus of 0 times 2 is 0. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 3 multiplied by minus 3. So this will be equal to minus 1 multiplied by minus 3, which is 3. Then A 2 2, so minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. So second row and the second column we have to add. 3 times 1 is 3, minus 1 times 2 is 2. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4. 3 minus 2 is 1. So this will be equal to 1 times 1, which is 1. Then A 2 3. So minus 1 raised to 2 plus 3. Second row and third column we have to hide. 0 times 1 is 0. Minus of 1 times minus 1 is minus 1. This will be equal to minus 1 raised to 5. 0 plus 1, this will be equal to minus 1 multiplied by 1, which is equal to minus 1. Then we will find A 3 1, this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 3 plus 1. Third row and the first column we have to hide. Minus 2 times minus 1 is 2, minus 0 times 2 is 0. So this will be equal to minus 1 raised to 4 times 2, that will be equal to 1 times 2, which is 2. Then A 3 2, so minus 1 raised to 3 plus 2. Third row and second column we have to hide. Minus 2 times 1, that is minus 2. 3 times 2 is minus 6, which is equal to minus 1 raised to 5 times minus 2 minus 6 is minus 8, that will be equal to minus 1 times minus 8, that is 8. Then A 3 3, which is minus 1 raised to 3 plus 3. Third row and third column we have to hide. 0 times 1 is 0, minus 3 times minus 1 is minus 3. So minus 1 raised to 6, 0 plus 3, this will be equal to 1 times 3, which is 3. So we have got every cofactor. Now we can find the adjoint. So adjoint of A will be equal to transpose of A 1 1, A 1 2, A 1 3, A 2 1, A 2 2, A 2 3, A 3 1, A 3 2, A 3 3. So this will be equal to transpose of A 1 1, which is 0, A 1 2, which is minus 11, A 1 3, which is 0, A 2 1, which is 3, A 2 2, which is 1, A 2 3, which is minus 1, A 3 1, which is 2, A 3 2, which is 8, and A 3 3, which is 3. This will be equal to, now we are finding adjoint of A. So transpose of this matrix, that will be what we have to interchange the rows and columns. So first row will become first column, So 0 minus 11, 0. 3, 1 minus 1 will become the second column, and third row, that is 2, 8, 3 will become third column. So 2, 8, 3. This is adjoint of A. Now we can start verifying. So A times adjoint of A, so that will be equal to A is 1 minus 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 2, and 1, 0, 3 times adjoint of A is 0, 3, 2, minus 11, 1, 8, and 0, minus 1, 3. So this will be equal to, we have to multiply first row, first column. So 1 times 0 is 0, minus 1 times minus 11 is plus 11, and 2 times 0 is 0. First row, second column, 1 times 3 is 3, minus 1 times minus 1 is minus 1, 2 times minus 1 is minus 2. First row, third column, 1 times 2 is 2, minus 1 times 8 is minus 8, 2 times 3 is 6. Second row, first column, 3 times 0 is 0, 0 times minus 11 is 0, minus 2 times 0 is 0. Second row, second column, 3 times 3 is 9, 0 times 1 is 0, minus 2 times minus 1 is plus 2. Second row, third column, 3 times 2 is 6, 0 times 8 is 0, minus 2 times 3 is minus 6. Third row, first column, 0 times 1 is 0, 0 times minus 11 is 0, and 3 times 0 is 0. Third row, second column, 1 times 3 is 3, 0 times 1 is 0, 3 times minus 1 is minus 3. Third row, third column, 1 times 2 is 2, 0 times 8 is 0, 3 times 3 is 9. So what we will get here, this will be equal to this is 11, 0 plus 11 plus 0, 11, 3 minus 1, which is 2, 2 minus 2 is 0, 2 minus 8 is minus 6, plus 6 will be 0, this is 0, 9 plus 2 is 11. 6 minus 6 is 0. This is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0. And 2 plus 9 is 11. So we have found A times adjoint of A. Now we will call this as 1. Now we will do adjoint of A times A, so that will be equal to adjoint of A is here 0, 3, 2, minus 11, 1, 8, 0, minus 1, 3 times A. So, which is 1 minus 1, 2, then 3, 0 minus 2, 1, 0, 3. So, this will be equal to You have to multiply the first row and the first column. So 0 times 1 is 0, 3 times 3 is 9, 2 times 1 is 2, first row, second column, 0 times minus 1 is 0, 3 times 0 is 0, 2 times 0 is 0, first row, third column, 0 times 2 is 0, 3 times minus 2 is minus 6, 2 times 3 is 6. Second row, first column, minus 11 times 1 is minus 11, 1 times 3 is 3, 8 times 1 is 8. Second row, second column, minus 11 times minus 1 is 11, 1 times 0 is 0, 8 times 0 is 0. Second row, third column, minus 11 times 2 is minus 22. 1 times minus 2 is minus 2, 8 times 3 is plus 24. Third row, first column, 0 times 1 is 0, minus 1 times 3 is minus 3, 3 times 3 is plus 3. Third row, second column, 0 times minus 1 is 0, minus 1 times 0 is 0, 3 times 0 is 0. Third row, third column, 0 times 2 is 0, minus 1 times minus 2 is plus 2, and 3 times 3 is 9. So what we will get, this will be equal to 9 plus 2 is 11, then this is 0, minus 6 plus 6 is 0, minus 11 plus 3 is minus 8, plus 8 is 0, 11, minus 2, minus 2 is minus 24, plus 24, it is 0, minus 3 plus 3 is 0, 0 here, 2 plus 9 is 11. So what we have found is adjoint of A times A. We will call this as 2. Now we will find determinant of A times I. So for the determinant of A we have to find. Determinant is what? 1 minus 1, 2. Three zero minus two, one zero three. So this will be equal to 1 times 3 multiplied by 0 minus 0 multiplied by minus 2, which is 0, then minus of minus 1, so that is plus 1, times 3 is 9. Minus 1 times minus 2 is minus 2, plus 2 times 0 times 3 is 0, minus 1 times 0 is 0. This will be equal to 1 times 0 plus 9 plus 2 plus 2 times 0, that will be equal to 0 plus 9 plus 2 is 11, 11 times 1 will be 11, plus 0, this is equal to 11. So determinant of A is 11. So now we can find determinant of A times I. So this will be equal to 11 times identity matrix, which is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So this will be equal to 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. This is determinant of A times I. So we will call this as 3. So you can look at 1, 2 and 3 and you can see that all are equal. Matrix 1 is 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. matrix 2 is 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11, and matrix 3 also is 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. So all are equal. So from 1, 2 and 3 we get A times adjoint of A, adjoint of A times A is equal to determinant of A times I. Okay, so hence verified. So that was problem number 4. So that's it in the video. If you have liked my video, please hit the like button and please do subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed. I'll see you in the next video.